And if I have someone who answers with a 1, and that indicates they're highly perfectionistic, as it does on these last two questions, then what if I flipped or literally reversed the scale so that someone who answers down here, instead of a 1, they now get a 7? And someone who answers with a 2, instead of a 2, they get the reverse score, or a 6. And I show you down here how that works. So on these two items, I never aim for perfection on my work. If I'm highly perfectionistic, then I'm going to answer a 1 once again. But it's a perfectionism scale, so people who are high on it should have high scores. So this 1 is not going to be a 1 anymore, but it's reverse coded into a 7. So you can see that here. So a 1 becomes a 7, and as you'll see, the scale is just literally reversed or flip-flopped. A 2 becomes a 6, a 3 becomes a 5, a 4 stays a 4, a 5 becomes a 3, a 6 is a 2, and a 7 is 1. So next, I'll go ahead and show you how to do that in SPSS. And thankfully, it's not really very hard at all. Okay, so in SPSS, these four variables correspond to the four items we just looked at. And notice that the first person answered with 6s on the first two questions, which I call Perfect1, Perfect2. And then they answered with a 1 and 2 on Perfect3 and 4, respectively, those last two questions on the scale. So notice here, this person is answering high on questions 1 and 2 and low on questions 3 and 4. If you recall that scale from earlier, that indicates that they tend to respond in a perfectionistic way. The next person answers in the most extreme way. Notice that they have 7s on 1 and 2, and they have 1s on 3 and 4. And then if we scan through here, we can see some people who tend not to be perfectionistic at all, or very low in that regard. And that would be this person here, person number 3. They answer with a 1 and 2 on the first two questions, and then a 7 and 6 on the last two. So if you read through these once again and looked at these values, that should indicate someone who is not highly perfectionistic. Now, in SPSS, we're going to take our two negative items here, 3 and 4, or perfect 3 and 4, and reverse code them, where you saw that before, a 1 becomes a 7, and so on. So to do that, we want to go to transform, and then we want to go to recode into different variables. Now, a quick side note here that's very important. You could select recode into same variables, but if you did that, then what would happen is these values would be reversed, but they would overwrite the existing values. And that may be fine, that may be something that some people want to do, but I recommend not doing that. And the reason that is that if you recode into the same variable, then if you go back to this data set later, if several months have passed, for example, you may not remember if you reverse coded or recoded those values or not. And then you could go and recode them again and turn them back to the original way and get very confused. So I highly recommend, I always do to everyone I work with, that you select recode into different variables. And then we create new variables, and then we'll always know by doing that what the reverse coded variables are, and we'll never change the original variables. So go ahead and select recode into different variables. And then here the recode into different variables dialog box opens. Now recall we're working with perfect 3 and 4. So I'm going to go ahead and move perfect 3 over, and I can move perfect 4 over as well now if I want to. Let's go ahead and select perfect 3. And then in this output variable box, which you see over here, I'm going to go ahead and enter a new name. I'm going to call that perfect3. And then what I like to do is I like to put underscore R. And that tells me the R tells me it's a reverse coded item. And I just put the underscore there so that it stands out a little more. It's easier for me to see. So let's go ahead and click change there. And then once I click change, notice that it puts it over here. So this is saying perfect 3 will become perfect 3 underscore R. And in particular, we'll be making a new variable for that. Let's go ahead and do perfect 4 now. So click on that and then go to the name box and just enter perfect 4 underscore R. Click change. And then notice those two are there now. Now that didn't do anything in terms of telling SPSS to reverse code these values, but what we did was we created new variable names to hold the reverse coded values. So we're going to have a new variable perfect3_r and a second variable perfect4_r, which if this works correctly will show right up here. Okay, so next let's go ahead and reverse code those values. So to do that we go to the old and new values button. Go ahead and click on that.